Hi, welcome to DPV Technology. In this video, we will learn how to use this HC05 Bluetooth module with Arduino and with your Android phone. Let's get started.
You can buy all types of electronic components, modules, sensors at best price from www.dpvtechnology.com.
So we need a Bluetooth module, HC05 Bluetooth module, one Arduino Uno board, one LED to test the output, and some connecting jumper wires. Of course, you need a smartphone also. Here is our HC05 Bluetooth module. It has 6 pins here. So from out of 6 pins, we will use only these 4 pins: RXD, TXD, ZND, and VCC. We will not use this step and EN pin in this video. So let us first connect it to Arduino. So we have to connect this VCC pin of this module to VCC, that is 5 volt pin of the Arduino. So here is our 5 volt pin, this number 4 from this side. And then we have to connect this ground pin, that is ZND pin of this module, to ZND pin of the Arduino. There are 3 ground pins here, so we can connect it to any one of it. So we will connect it here. Next, we will connect this TX pin to RX pin of the Arduino. Don't connect the TX pin to TX pin of the Arduino. Connect TX to RX pin of the Arduino. And then RX pin of the module to TX pin of the Arduino. So now our connections are ready. So now I will connect an LED and I will control this LED through our mobile phone, that is Android phone. So I will connect it to pin number 12, the positive terminal, that is the longer terminal, to pin number 12 and another terminal to ZND pin of the Arduino. So if you use 5mm LED, then you can use a breadboard, and along with that LED, you have to use 100 ohm or 220 ohm resistor to protect the LED in series. So here is our code. You can download this code from the link given in the description of this video. So at the beginning of the code, we have defined the LED pin 12. Then we have defined a integer type variable data to store the data coming from the Bluetooth module. Then in the void setup, we have defined this LED pin as output. And at the beginning of the code, the LED will be in off state. So here is our baud rate 9600 for the Bluetooth module. The default baud rate of the Bluetooth module is 38400. You can set it 38400 also, but we will set 9600 in this case. So in the void loop section, we will first check whether serial dot available is greater than 0. That means if data is available or not. If data is available, then data is read and it is stored in the data variable. Then if the data is equal 0, then the LED pin will be low. That means the LED will be in off state. Then serial.println LED off. So this message will be print LED off in the serial monitor. Then else if data is equal 1, if data is 1, then digital write LED pin high. So LED will be on in this case, and a message will be printed LED on. Now we will upload the code. But before uploading the code, we have to disconnect these TX and RX wires from the Arduino module, Arduino board. After uploading, we have to connect it again with the Arduino board. So if you don't disconnect this, then you will get error. So it is uploaded. Now we will connect this two wires, that is TX RX wires, to the Arduino board. So now we have to download one application app for mobile to control this, to send command to this Bluetooth module. So let's do that. First we have to go to Play Store, then search Arduino Bluetooth control. So you can see there are lots of apps, so you can choose any one of it. So let us choose the first one and install it.
Now click open. Then here we can see available devices HC05. So before connecting to HC05, we can see this LED, the status LED is now blinking fast. That means it is not connected. After pairing, we can see this status LED blinks slowly. So let us connect it first. So device, here we have to use our password. So password for this HC05 is 000 or 1234. So let us try with 1234 and pair. So we can see the LED is now blinking slowly. So let us switch off this light so that you can see now the blinking rate is slow. Now go to terminal mode. Now here we can see type in command. That means from here we can send command. So in the code we have seen that when we send 0, the LED will be off, and when we send 1, then the LED will be on. LED will be in on state. So let's send 1 first, because at the beginning LED is always off. So here is loose connection. Okay, so when I send 1, we can see, okay, it is on now. Then when we send 0, we can see the LED is now off. Again we will send 1, so LED on. When we send 0, LED off. That means it is working.
You can buy all types of electronic components, modules, sensors at best price from www.dpvtechnology.com.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video, then please don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel for upcoming videos. Thank you.